when you graft the technical model onto ethics, what it becomes then is, just like there's 10 or 15 ways of dealing with this abscess, this surgical problem, this infection, there are a number of ways you can address moral issues as well. So you want all these sort of tools in your pocket, just like, you know, you have multiple antibiotics. We need multiple sort of moral programs that you can invoke on these sort of situations. And so my ethics training that I got in medical school was that there are schools of thought, such as deontology, such as utilitarianism, such as virtue ethics, such as feminist ethics. And then you sort of run a series of cases through those gamuts, and a feminist may say, a utilitarian may say, a virtue ethicist approach would be, and that's your ethical sort of training. The problem with that, though, is that the reason why we all sort of know that there's this moral quandaries in medicine is that actually that's essential to medical practice, and it always has been for thousands upon thousands of years, that what to do and ought you to do it are inextricably linked. And so the practice of medicine has always included this moral component. And in fact, you could not be a good doctor without also being a good moral philosopher. For 2,000 years, this was explicit. And we've sort of lost that as we've drifted into both, there's way more technical stuff to know, and two, we've lost our connection to the past, we've lost our connection to objective truth, objective reality, that sort of thing when it comes to moral questions. And so that's what's then left, is this sort of seeming need for something, but the only tools we have in the bag are to show you, well, these are just all options, and there's no right or wrong way at these things.